Good evening. I am Rabbi Howard Zak, spiritual leader at Congregation Torah Emet, the Main Street Synagogue, and it is my pleasure to introduce our honoree this evening, Julius Vargo. Over the years, our scholarship dinner has honored many outstanding community leaders and philanthropists. Tonight is no exception. Some of you may know Julius Vargo, but many of you may not. I have the pleasure of introducing you to one of the great longtime supporters of Torah Academy and one of Central Ohio's most kind and generous individuals. For at least 25 years, Julius and his family and business associates have not only financially supported CTA Scholarship Dinner, but attended the dinner with few exceptions. Quietly but consistently, Julius and the Vargo companies have made generous gifts to the school and then added to their support by attending the dinners. And their support is not only to Torah Academy Scholarship Dinner, but to many other events important to the Columbus Jewish community. The history of Julius and his family's kindness to our school goes back to the mid-1970s. Not long after he and his wife, Mary Ann, founded Vargo Companies in 1971, Julius and Jerome Schottenstein of blessed memory began a business relationship that carries on today with Jay Schottenstein and his companies. Through the hard work of Julius and Mary Ann, the Vargo Companies grew from a small material handling company to a major force in the field of innovative material handling integration solutions, establishing strong relationships with business heavyweights, such as Schottenstein Department Stores, Value City Furniture, DSW, American Eagle Outfitters, Honda Motor Company, The Limited, Amazon, and L.L. Bean, to name but a few. And as their business grew, Julius, Mary Ann, and their family never forgot those who helped them build that business into a big, big success. They gave back to the community in many ways, and fortunate for us, CTA became one of their beneficiaries. Please take a look at the video screen to learn more about our wonderful honoree, Julius Vargo.
He's a man of great character.
He really leaves a mark on the people that he touches.
His family's great.
You can see a definite a light up of people when he comes in the room.
Julius has been a regular supporter.
The importance of supporters like Julius Vargo to institutions like Columbus Torah Academy cannot be overstated.
He's been a great supporter all these years and a great friend.
He would do anything for anyone.
He's always been a sponsor. He's always had a full table.
It is a business relationship, but there are probably few people in business that I've had a better time with than Julius.
Julius and his family are nice people. They care about the school. They take a personal interest. And I think it's appropriate that Julius is our honoree this year. Goes back to my father and to my uncles of blessed memory. And his mother used to babysit my father and my uncles.
My grandparents lived on Reba Avenue in a small bungalow across from the Southside Settlement House. And the Schottensteins, of course, were Reba and Parsons. At that time, my mother, on occasion, I guess, babysat for the four boys. And so we technically go back to that day with the Schottenstein organization. She spoke of it often.
If I had to use adjectives to describe my dad, The first one would be family-oriented.
You know, growing up in a business that, your parents start, it's natural to be close because it's all you know.
When we started, we intended this to be a family organization. I wanted them to be close, and it would also give them the opportunity, hopefully, if the business was successful, that everyone would benefit from it.
From the time we were little kids, we've been working in this business. And we worked in our garage, we worked in the basement. I mean, we just did odds and ends, worked in the warehouse. And so they have a very strong work ethic.
My kids, they have been with us all through this whole fight. And fortunately, as I've gotten out of it now, we passed off the business to Mike. The girls are still very, very much involved.
What I have taken away from the relationship that I've had with my dad is the fact that he's been a very best friend. He's been a great mentor. And, you know, I'd like to be, at the end of the day, I'd like to be viewed as I know he is.
My first impression of Julius has really been the lasting impression, namely that he is a man of integrity who genuinely cares about our business. Always felt like we were very important to them. And as a result, there was a lot of motivation on both sides to work toward lasting solutions, not just the order of the moment, but how do we build for the future working together.
I felt that rather than just be a salesman, we needed a relationship to help people. Let me have the responsibility to find, to fix the problem. I don't care if it's a caster or a $1 million opportunity. I want to do it for you.
The thing that separates Julius and his company from the rest, in my opinion, is the fact that they truly are problem solvers.
Julius, through the years, has been involved with all of our warehousing, working on problem solving, get efficiencies in our warehousing, making sure we have the state-of-the-art systems, and they bring great people with them too.
He always is willing to listen and offer advice when he's asked for advice. And I think that's important, and I think that makes people feel secure and willing and open to go to him.
You know, he always wanted to make sure that he was available. And it was just part of his, I think, not so much even the business relationship that he was developing, but it was also part of the friendship that he was developing. And he always wanted to be the one in the front that was helping.
Private education is very important to mom and dad both. And so the contribution and the involvement with the Torah Academy, with the Ohio State University, with the Wexner Medical Center, you know, things like that that are important to them that they've passed along.
Mr. Vargo, in his personal life, appreciates the importance of faith-based education. He is wise in understanding that faith-based crosses all denominations and all faiths, and that our society is best served when everybody has a good, solid education grounded in their particular faith.
You know, just the values of that Catholic Church played out in Mom and Dad's daily life. The commandments, they live by the commandments, and live your life right, live your life for God, and you get rewarded, and they obviously have been.
I believe in discipline. I believe in the religion, the religious aspect that the children are raised with, and that's just part of our being, if you will. That's another reason why I have a very soft spot in my heart for the Torah Academy. And that's just why I feel so strongly about it.
Walking through the hallways of Columbus Torah Academy with Julius, I'm sure that what he was most impressed with was the smiling faces of the children, the enthusiasm that they exhibit, and the warmth and the kindness and the nurturing that the teachers extend to the students. That's got to be very, very impressive, and I know that being the person that he is, that this would particularly resonate for him.
We try to do as much as we can to help others, because we certainly have had a lot of help ourselves. It's very important to me because it I truly believe in the discipline and in the education that is given in a private school. I think it helps their faith, it helps their understanding of what life is about. The better you're dressed, the better you feel about yourself, the better you behave. And the satisfaction that I get out of that is hoping that I've, in some small way, helped those people, those children. So that's why I want to stick with what we do.
Our parents salute you, Mr. Vargo. We appreciate what you do because on your behalf, children are able to receive this wonderful and outstanding education.
As a community, they have people like Julius and his family that aren't Jewish but have taken the interest in the school. Because it's easy for people to say, well, I only support my own kind or my own school. But to see someone who's taken an interest, and these are very special people. And thank God we have friends like this.
You can count on me, cause I can count on you.
Julius, will you please join me on the dais? Julius, take a bow. Julius, on behalf of the Columbus Torah Academy, faculty, staff, parents, and students, it's my pleasure to present to you this beautiful framed print, which expresses a verse from the Torah about the pursuit of fairness and righteous acts of justice. The inscription on the plaque reads, "Presented to Julius and Marianne Vargo for their friendship and generous support of Torah Academy, presented at the CTA Scholarship Dinner, November 23rd, 2014, 1 Kislev, 5775.
Thank you. Thank you.
Can I say a few words?
Yes.
Unaccustomed to public speaking as I am, I have a few notes that I will say something. Good evening, friends in faith. It is a privilege to stand here on behalf of my wife, Marianne, my family, and our associates to accept this wonderful honor. Many of the values Marianne and I possess came to us through private faith-based education. We carry these important teachings with us today, the way we raise our children and in our professional relationships. These lessons are the foundation of our company. For us, the opportunity to work with Columbus Torah Academy is an easy labor. We don't even think about it. We just do it. We believe deeply in the mission here. We believe in faith-based private schools that provide our future leaders with quality education shaped by social values. This will impact them through their life. We believe in the benefits of having a meaningful relationship with teachers who are dedicated to these young minds. They engage in mentoring and encouraging the students to apply themselves, give back, and improve the world in which we live and work. Thank you for allowing Marianne and I and my family to be a part of the Columbus Torah mission. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Julius, once again, congratulations on your well-deserved honor. Thank you for giving us the opportunity to honor you this evening.
Before we conclude our program, followed by dessert, we want to thank all of our sponsors, volunteers, and Torah Academy staff who worked on various aspects of the scholarship dinner. A special thank you to Liz and Jeremy Califf for creating the honoree video.
One final announcement. Before you leave, please take one final look at the silent auction tables because the auction is closing in 5 minutes after the conclusion of our comments. The check-in will be in the back of the ballroom. Dessert will be served in the reception hall. Shortly, David Polster, a 12th grade student at Torah Academy, will lead the Birkat Hamazon. Shalom and enjoy the rest of your evening.